Click on the subscribe button to subscribe to our channel. Press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Am I audible now?
Yes. Yes.
Thank you. Okay, my name is Abhishek. I will be taking questions of history and art and culture. So we only have one question of art and culture and five questions of modern history and world history. Anyways, before starting the session, I would like your input. What did you think of the paper, especially this section? Kaisa tha history ke question? Kaise lage? Very good. Why very good? Kaisa laga? Kisi ne kuch trend koshish kiya kya pata karne ka? How UPSC is changing their trend in history questions especially. Why I am asking this? Because frankly, I couldn't find one. I feel like that history mein aisa hota hai ki bahut hi obvious se question bhi aa jate hain aur kabhi aise bahut hi mushkil question bhi aa jayenge, bahut hi abstract se question bhi aa sakte hain, and there is no certain trend. So for example, if I have to find trend in geography questions, I can say that environmental geography pe focus hai. ऐसे बोल सकते हैं, पिछले दो तीन साल में इन्वायरमेंटल ज्योग्राफी के क्वेश्चंस बहुत सारे आ रहे हैं. सोसाइटी में भी थोड़ा बहुत बोला जा सकता है, बट हिस्ट्री में आई फील लाइक इधर क्वेश्चंस हैव बीन वेरी वेरी स्पेसिफिक और वेरी ब्रॉड. सो फॉर एग्जांपल, वी विल सी दैट देयर आर सम वेरी फैक्चुअल क्वेश्चंस आल्सो, सम वेरी एनालिटिकल क्वेश्चंस, वेरी गुड क्वेश्चंस आल्सो ऑफ हिस्ट्री. एंड वन थिंग, द वेटेज हैज इंक्रीज लिटिल बिट. सो फॉर एग्जांपल, सिक्स क्वेश्चंस ऑफ सोसाइटी, 8 questions of geography, and in 6 questions of history and art and culture, there is 1 of art and culture, 3 of modern history, and 2 questions of world history. 2 questions hai, world history ke 2 question hai, because abhi aise lag raha hai ki world history ka sirf ek question hai, American and French Revolution wala jo question hai, but jo usse just upar wala question hai, wo bhi world history ka hi question hai, agar aap usko theek se padho. India wahan pe kahin pe mention nahi hai. Anyways, we will discuss that question also. We are talking about the decolonization, the problems created by British in decolonization. Let's start with question number 1. Now this is a very famous question. This was also asked by UPSC in 2014 in a very different form. So the question is, highlight the Central Asian and Greco-Bactrian elements in the Gandhara art. Now a question jo 2014 mein pucha tha, wo ye tha that Gandhara sculpture owed as much to Romans as to Greeks. Explain. So in that question you had to, अभी तक हम होता क्या गंधार आर्ट क्या पढ़ते हैं, the only thing we read कि ग्रीक रोमन इन्फ्लुएंस है. Yes. Okay, I will definitely. So the question was, I'm saying that in 2014 the question was that Gandhara art owes both to Greeks as well as Romans. Now that was also a very interesting question, because when you generally read, we read Greco-Roman influence. You do not differentiate what is Greek influence and what is Roman influence. Now they have made it even more challenging this year. So the question, same thing, not specific to sculpture, but yes, Gandhara art is known for sculpture, but Central Asian influence and Greco-Bactrian influence. You have to clearly demarcate that what are the influences from Central Asian and Greco-Bactrian region in Gandhara art. Can you guys tell me some points? How to start? कैसे कर सकते हैं? How to start this question? In introduction, what can we mention? Alexander, okay. Anything else? Time period of Gandhara art? First to fourth century, during Kushan Empire, especially it reached its zenith. So Kushan, and especially during Kanishk, the time period of Kanishk. Which region of the country? Northwest. Right now, if we have to pinpoint, it will be some regions of Pakistan as well as Afghanistan. Right. So we are talking about Gandhara art and why there is a Greco-Roman influence as well as Central Asian influence. Yes, the close proximity as well as series of invasions and migrations from these regions. So first thing you have to remember, why Central Asian, many people got confused what to write in Central Asia. The first thing you have to know that Kushana Empire itself came from Central Asia. So there is a Central Asian influence. For example, if I have to point out some things, ki what are Central Asian influence? So for example, you'll find that in Gandhara art, there is a lot of Zoroastrian influence. So for example, in motifs, there are fire altars. There is a So if there is a circumference, you will find that symbolism of fire is there, and fire is directly related to Zoroastrianism. Zoroastrianism developed in Iran, though it is part of Iran, but also it influenced a lot of Central Asian art. So the influence of fire hai, that can be one Central Asian influence. What other thing you can write, think of in Central Asian influence in Gandhar art? The clothings of Buddha. So for example, you will find that Buddha is wearing turban. Buddha is wearing long dresses. Now these clothings, especially in Buddha's standing position. So these influences directly again come from Central Asian region. So the clothing of Buddha is very important here. So that is a Central Asian influence. Also, whenever there is like a group of sculptures been made, you'll find that the musical tradition depicted in Gandhara art is directly inspired from musical tradition of Central Asian region. So that can be one point. So there are, so again, this question is factual in nature. You have to know the facts, only then you can answer. So especially ye jo first wala part hai. The second part is very easy because we know everybody, whenever somebody reads about Gandhara art, the first thing you read is that it had Greco-Roman influence. Greco-Bactrian Empire ka bahut sara influence hai. So first part was difficult because generally we do not read it, and generally it is not covered in the standard textbook which we read. So for example, either you read NCERT or NIOS or even Nitin Singhania's book, you will not find a specific mention about Central Asian influence. So that's why this part was difficult. But what about the second part? What can we write there? Greco-Bactrian elements. Yes, exactly. So for example, jo Buddha's he is depicted as Greek gods like Zeus, Apollo, Atlas. So for example, Buddha has been depicted as a muscular god. That is the first thing. Second thing, also the Buddha's halo, jo sar pe hai, and the Buddha's hair pattern, that is again directly inspired from Greek pantheons, jo Greek and Roman pantheons. For example, the wavy hair and the halo which is worn by Buddha, that directly takes inspiration from Greco-Roman Empire. So that you can write. Many times you will also find that in sculptures, Buddha has been depicted along with other Greek pantheons. Like there have been sculptures where Atlas is protecting a Buddhist monastery. Now Atlas is a Roman god. So you can mention that. Jo cupids hote hain, you know, cupids in Greek, cupids, angels, small angels of love, if somebody knows about them. So you'll find that similar representation of cupids is in Gandhara art. So these are again Greek influence. So there are n number of examples. So second part was easy because second part you will find in any standard textbook that what are Greco-Roman influence in Gandhara art. So that you can write. But first part was little bit tricky here because it is not generally mentioned. But thoda bahut phir bhi likh sakte ho. Even if you do not know, so for example, if you know the origin of Kushan Empire, you can at least write some factual things. For example, Kushan migrated from the Central Asian region. So that you can write, that you can mention. So, yes, you can talk about Bamiyan Buddha. So Bamiyan Buddha jo Afghanistan mein jo bade sculptures hai, yes, that is a very good example of Central Asian influence. So yes, Bamiyan Buddha will be a very good example. So we can write few points, but the first part especially was difficult because of lack of sources in our standard textbook. Any doubt here? So 150 marks, introduction, 20 words, around 20 words, 60 words, first part, second part, 60 words. That's it, okay? Ek thoda sa conclusion agar aapko likhna ho, you can write a conclusion, you can also skip it. Writing conclusion here is not important. There are questions where you have to write conclusion. Here you can skip it. It's not important here. Any doubt here in the question number one? A factual question. This is a factual question. There is no analysis here. If you know the factual information, you can write it. Otherwise, you can also skip it. Okay, let's come to the question number two. Yes. I just said that you can skip the conclusion. But anyways, the conclusion can be that Gandhara art also takes influence. So for example, not only Central Asian, you'll find that there is Iranian influence also. And it also inspired other art forms. So for example, later sculptures. So for example, you'll find that there is a similarity between, although Mathura art and Gandhara art quite different, but you'll at least find some similarities there. So that can be a conclusion. So it had foreign influence but it inspired other sculpture tradition. That can be a conclusion. So there can be any conclusion. You can skip it also. Soft power in these countries. Bol sakte ho? Yes. Soft power, art and culture ka question hai. Hum soft power ko hum skip kar sakte hai, but theek hai. Yes, in way forward, we can mention, so for example, ye jo relationship hai, that is actually a valid point. So for example, agar aap, if you are reading newspaper regularly, jab bhi, whenever you talk about India-Korea relation, we talk of this princess who went to Korea to marry a Korean prince. Now, government often invokes this story. It might be a mythical story. So government invokes this story to enhance our relationship. So yes, you can write that there was the Central Asian region hai, jo hamara West Asian region hai. So we can use Gandhara to enhance our influence, but skip bhi kar sakte ho, not necessary. You have to mention it. Anyways, let's come to question number 2. Yes. I really cannot answer you. So for example, I will just say that whatever sources you are reading, read that. So for example, if you go and search about Gandhara art and especially Central Asian influence, you will find these points. But in standard textbook which you read, you will not find these points. For example, jo maine Buddha ke dressing ki baat ki, ya jo fire influence ka baat kiya, so musical tradition ka baat ki, you will find these references in some PDFs on internet, but not on specific textbook. So do not bother about ki kaun se source se padhe. Jo aap sources padh rahe hain, so for example, if you are reading Nitin Singhania, if you are reading NIOS, if you are reading CCRT, it's more than sufficient. The reason I am telling you, this is an input-output game. So for example, if you go and read A.L. Basham, jo ki bahut hi moti kitab hai, to answer just one question, it will be a very useless thing to do, right? So for one question, you do not have to devote a lot of time to reading n number of books. Jo bhi standard textbook hai, wo padho. At least by reading standard textbook, you can write the second part of the answer. Okay, so do not bother about that I have to read all the sources. Anyways, let's come to question number 2. The 1857 uprising was the culmination of recurrent big and small local rebellions that had occurred in the preceding 100 years of British rule. Elucidate. Again, this is a very good question. Now, this was a question people expected in 2017. In 2017, there was a talk of Paika Rebellion. So Paika Rebellion is considered as one of the most, yes, first independence movement which happened in Orissa. So that time, in fact, I remember that in Vijayan IAS test series, this question was asked in 2017, not this year. So what were other revolutions before 1857 which can be considered important? So again, this is a factual question. There is no analysis here as such. You have to, whatever revolutions you can think of, you can remember, you have to write here. The more examples you will give in limited words, 150 words mein answer karna hai, the better marks you will get. So think of you, yes, the very first and very important. In fact, we can categorize these revolutions in different forms. So especially, for example, there can be a politico-religious movement. There can be also tribal and peasant movements. And also movements led by zamindars and upper classes. Zamindars and local kings. So this can be one of the classifications. Ab iske example batao. So politico-religious movement ka agar, if I have to write examples, think of your examples. Sorry? Yes, Wahhabi movement will be a very good example. So there are two at least very important examples. One is Sanyasi. So we can talk about Sanyasi. No, it was before 1857. It started much before 1857. So Wahhabi movement, yes, that will be a very good example. If you can remember the timeline, you should mention the timeline. If you cannot, you can skip it. But agar time period nahi bhi yaad hai, you have to mention the region. Achha, one good thing which you can do in this answer, try to give examples of these movements from different part of the country. Like, do not concentrate in a certain part. Ki sare movements humne Bengal ka likha ho. या साउथ इंडिया का लिखा हो. सो वी हैव टू फोकस ऑन डिफरेंट पार्ट ऑफ द कंट्री. सो दैट द क्वेश्चन, वट इज द क्वेश्चन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट, वॉज द कल्मिनेशन ऑफ रिकरेंट बिग एंड स्मॉल local rebellious. So we have to talk about that there is a general resentment against British rule across the India. So try to find examples from different part of the country. So yes, Sanyasi, if you, kaun se region mein hota Sanyasi? Awadh and Bengal region. Who were Sanyasis? Why this revolution occurred? Sanyasi rebellion occurred? So the immediate cause was very simple. There were restrictions on visiting holy sites. That was the immediate cause. However, there is a background also because of land revenue system, because how, who were sannyasis? Ye sannyasis kaun hai? Yes, sannyasis, most of the time they were farmers. They also served Marathas. They also served Bengal, Nawab of Bengal, Nawab of Awadh. And they did not like how they are being treated by Britishers, as well as the economic policy of Britishers were very much discriminatory, and that's why Sanyasi rebellion started. But the immediate cause was restrictions imposed on the visiting of holy sites. So you can mention that. What was the Wahhabi movement? Yes, so it was that. So Wahhabi movement directly got inspiration from Wahhab, jo Wahhabi Islam hai, and its focus was that the Britishers, they are creating problem in India, and the British jo rule hai, that is a direct threat to existence of Islam, and that's why on the lines of teachings of Wahhab, the Wahhabi movement started. It happened in 1803, started in 1803 and continued till 1860. Theek hai? So yes, it continued till 1860, even after 1857, but it started much earlier. So we can mention that also. Kaun se region mein? Yes, so basically it was limited to not only Bengal, but also north, some regions of North India. Okay, but not in Southern India, but in Bengal and North India, the Wahhabi movement was very much prevalent. So what about tribal and peasant movements? Sorry? Yes, you can write, talk about Bhil uprising. Aur batao. Sabse, nahin, Munda bahut baad mein hua tha. Munda happened in 1900, so usko hum hatayenge. Santhal will be a very good example. Paika rebellion we are talking about. Paika rebellion. A home uprising happened here. Can you think of any more examples of peasant movement? Sorry? Munda baad mein hua tha, main bol raha tha, Munda happened after 1857. So Munda, yes, coal uprising we can talk about. Yes, we can talk about coal uprising. But just writing name will not be sufficient. You have to explain it in at least one line, that which part of the country was affected and who participated in these rebellions. Itna bhi likh doge, it will be more than sufficient. So again, this was a factual question. The more examples you will provide, the better marks you will get. Achha, what about movements by Jamindars and local kings? Yes, Polygar will be a very good example. Who are these Polygars? These were landlords in Tamil Nadu, in Southern India. And they were being discriminated in land revenue collection. So this started on the question of who will collect the revenue. Polygars were supposed to do that traditionally, but Britishers replaced them. So Polygar war started. This also started in starting of 18th century. And in fact, it continued. Or example batao. Sorry. Kitura. Yes, we can talk about Kitura uprising also. That can be mentioned. Give me more examples. Deccan rights. Deccan rights. No, Deccan rights. Ko hum, ha, we can mention Deccan rights. Yes. Sorry. हाँ, बहुत सारे हुए थे. तो हम जितना एग्जाम्पल हम लिखेंगे उतना ज्यादा हमारे लिए रहेगा. और हमें कोशिश करना है, वी हैव टू जस्ट फोकस ऑन दिस फैक्ट दैट वी आर ट्राइंग टू प्रोवाइड एग्जाम्पल्स फ्रॉम डिफरेंट पार्ट ऑफ द कंट्री. ठीक है, रामोसी अपराइजिंग कैन बी अनदर एग्जाम्पल. रामोसी अपराइजिंग कहां पे हुआ था? महाराष्ट्र. सो रामोसी अपराइजिंग हैपेंड इन महाराष्ट्र. सो वी हैव टू मेंशन, जो फॉर एग्जाम्पल यहां पे स्पेशली राइटिंग दिस आंसर, योर प्रिलिम्स इंफॉर्मेशन विल बी वेरी हेल्पफुल. वी रीड दिस थिंग्स फॉर प्रीलिम्स एग्जामिनेशन, बिकॉज मेंस में क्या होता है, थीम बेस्ड क्वेश्चन आता है, देयर इज अ प्रॉपर थीम. सो फॉर एग्जांपल जो नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन हम डिस्कस करेंगे नाउ, दैट इज जनरली अ टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन यू एक्सपेक्ट इन मेंस एग्जामिनेशन. सच टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन इज नॉट एक्सपेक्टेड, बट सच टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन इज एक्सपेक्टेड इन प्रीलिम्स एग्जामिनेशन. So whatever you are reading for prelims examination will also be very much valuable in mains examination. And this is a trend not specific to history, but in other papers also, be it geography, be it environment, even in economy perhaps. Okay, any doubt here? This was a straightforward question. The more number of examples you put, yes. Of you. Yes, yes, yes. You have to, so for example, ye examples are important, and yes, you are right. So you have to write the causes. Ye jo causes hai, wahan pe issues aayenge. So just writing example will not be sufficient. No, this will not, yes, you are right. Just writing names will not be sufficient. You will have to explain it in one or two line that why these rebellions happened. And in conclusion, here conclusion, writing conclusion will be important. In conclusion, you can write that there was a resentment across the country against British rule, which finally culminated into 1857 revolt. So yes, you have to focus on the issues, but without writing examples, khali issues likhna bhi nahi hoga, aur khali example without writing issues, both will not be a good answer. You have to give examples, and you'll also have to explain that what were the problems specific to this rebellion. We can mention that, yes, we can mention that Vellore mutiny is a very good example. There were some sepoy mutinies also before 1857. We can mention that. So whatever example can you think of, you can write it there. Okay, let's come to question number 3. Now this is a very good question, one of my favorite questions of the paper. Examine the linkages between the 19th century's India's Renaissance and the emergence of national identity. Before I say something, I want your input. What exactly you are supposed to write here? Now this is a proper analytical question. Acha, I'm really sorry. Question number 3. Examine the linkages between the 19th century's India's Renaissance and the emergence of national identity. क्या पूछ रहे हैं एग्जैक्टली? सो टाइम पीरियड दे रखा है 19th सेंचुरी, ये जो टाइम पीरियड दे रखा है, दिस इज अ वेरी गुड हिंट दैट व्हाट एग्जैक्टली यू आर सपोज्ड टू राइट. यस, गो अहेड. That is a very good approach. So exactly the approach you have to follow in answer. So for example, see here, generally when we talk about Indian Renaissance, it is divided into certain phases, and the first and second Renaissance which we talk about. So for example, when we talk about the first Renaissance in India, this happened with socio-religious reform movement. And the second Renaissance, if you have to talk about, then so for example, even before that, defining nationalism is a very tricky thing. So for example, we know that the concept of nation states emerged in Europe, right, after Industrial Revolution. Now this nation state, when it emerged in Europe, it was based on a similar common language. So for example, there is a French Empire, there is an English Empire, Italian Empire, German Empire. Now what bounds India as a nation? That is a very good question, and actually this is a very debatable question and an emerging question also. Like, you cannot provide a fixed answer ki what defines us as a nation. The idea of India bara hi abstract cheez hai. Ye jo idea of India hai, what constitutes this idea of India? There is a question, I think two questions in society, jo ki Anjani sir discuss karenge. But from historical perspective, so for example, if you have to say few things what defines us as a nation? The issues we have faced collectively. So we have a shared history. Shared history defines us. What else? Sorry? Yes, values and principles. Yes, you can talk about. Freedom movement is also constitution. Yes, constitution can also be said. Values, freedom movement is a very good example. Freedom movement defines us as a nation. But what about during freedom movement? For example, abhi to phir bhi aapne freedom movement ka example de diya. But what about during freedom movement itself? At what that time, what defined India as a nation? Patriotism. Patriotism ka basis kya hai? Jaise for example, I said ki Europe mein patriotism ka basis is language. That German people have to be reunited. What is the basis of patriotism here? Rights of? Yes, see, this is, so in this answer, you have to take this path that how from socio-religious reform movement, the focus shifted to Britishers. So for example, the leaders in 19th century, most of them generally believed in the goodwill of Britishers. That they are, so for example, two type of reforms happened. What happened in 19th century? There is a suddenly a foreign power with very limited number, they have occupied the entire Indian subcontinent. That is the first development. Because of that, there is a growing inferiority among Indians itself. But the third development which happened was the introduction of Western education. Now people got to know about many Western philosophers. And at the same time, many people inquired about ancient Indian literature itself. And they got to know that is a Western philosophy, this is not that great compared to our ancient philosophy. So this led to two types of movements. One was reformist movement, that there are certain problems in our society. And another was revivalist movement, that we have. So for example, Arya Samaj will be a very good example of revivalist movement. Brahmo Samaj will be a very good example of reformist movement. So people did realize that there are common threads, common problem across the country. For example, when you talked about issues faced by women or issues faced by untouchables, people of lower caste, etc. And we have to get rid of this problem. So this was a common thread. And because of this, in northern part of the country, a lot of religious reforms movement started, which were led by middle classes. In southern India, it was led by lower caste. So for example, people like Periyar, Narayan Guru. So those were caste movements. But यहां तक आंसर सफिशिएंट नहीं होगा इतना अगर आप खाली लिखोगे दैट इज नाउ नोवेयर इट इज टॉकिंग अबाउट नेशनलिज्म नाउ फ्रॉम हियर हाउ डिड वी रीच टू इंडियन नेशनलिज्म दिस इज द पाथ यू हैव टू टेक इन योर आंसर सो नाउ यू हैव टू व्हाट यू हैव टू हाईलाइट दैट इज जो इनिशियल गुडविल है दैट देयर इज अ गुडविल इन ब्रिटिश एम्पायर दिस गुडविल इज नॉट वेरी सब्सटेंशिएटेड इन फैक्ट ब्रिटिशर्स आर एक्सप्लॉइटिंग अस एंड There is a common enemy. So for example, India has its own set of problem. Different sections of the society have different aspirations. There is rarely a common thread which unites all of us, except the fact that there is an outsider enemy, right? And that outsider enemy is exploiting us. So what started as a reformist movement in the society that we have to get rid of problems like caste system, or woman, we have to talk about woman empowerment, we have to talk about your religious sacrifices, and we have to talk against that. So what started as socio-religious reform movement later took a turn that we have to fight a common enemy, which is Britishers. And that is the rise of Indian nationalism. That, ye jo common problems hai humare, jaise for example, caste wala jo problem hai, this is prevalent across the country. Problem which women face that is prevalent across the country. And apart from that, there is an enemy also which is exploiting us and that is also prevalent across the country. So what happened because of this thing, that ye jo different aspirations hain, that took a backstage. So there is a lot of division in the society. That took a backstage. And for most of the Indian nationalists, getting rid of Britishers became a primary goal. So that was the emergence of Indian nationalism. And this is the answer which you have to write. Yes, go ahead. बिल्कुल एकदम लिख सकते हैं, जो सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ आंसर में यही सब चीजें लिखनी पड़ेंगी आपको. सो ही इज सेइंग दैट कैन वी राइट अबाउट दादा भाई नौरोजी, आरसी दत्त एंड देयर इकोनॉमिक ड्रेन थ्योरी. यस यू हैव टू राइट दैट. सो इन फर्स्ट पार्ट यू विल टॉक अबाउट सोशियो रिलीजियस रिफॉर्म मूवमेंट्स, विच टॉक्ड अबाउट गेटिंग रिड ऑफ आवर ओन सोशल इविल्स एंड एट द सेम टाइम मेनी ऑफ देम बिलीव्ड इन द गुडविल ऑफ ब्रिटिशर्स, बट लेटर दे रियलाइज दैट नो दिस इज नॉट द फैक्टर, इन फैक्ट ब्रिटिशर्स आर एक्सप्लॉइटिंग अस. For example, economic drain theory propounded by leaders like Dada Bhai Nauroji or R.C. Dutt, and how that led to emergence of Indian nationalism. You can, yes, you can write that. Yes, you can. तो यही तो कर रहे हैं हम. आपने बिल्कुल ही जो आपने पकड़ा है क्वेश्चन का जिस्ट भी यही है. यस यू आर राइट. सो फॉर एग्जांपल इन द फर्स्ट पार्ट यू हैव टू टॉक अबाउट दैट देयर आर सोशल इश्यूज व्हिच इज पार्ट ऑफ आवर कल्चर, बट दैट इज देयर, बट अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट देयर इज ऑल्सो कॉमन एनिमी व्हिच वी हैव टू फाइट. सो ये जो पाथ है यू हैव टू एक्सप्लेन दिस पाथ, यू हैव टू टेक दिस एक्सप्लेन दिस पाथ दैट हाउ socio religious reform movement led to mass awakening and that mass awakening finally translated to fighting against britishers and few people. So for example ye kuch example aapko likhna hai, for example examples role played by western education or few people, few indians who went outside and came back. So you have to economic exploitation theory given by leaders like Dada Bhai Nauroji and R.C. Dutt. So you have to write down all these examples, especially in emergence of early phases of Indian nationalism. ठीक है? Any doubt here in this question? आगे बढ़े? But how you will relate with Indian Renaissance? Fighting against Britishers, yes. तो Indian Renaissance हम connect नहीं करेंगे. What we will say that जो exploitative tendency है from these acts, this exploitative tendency was further became more people became aware about those exploitative tendencies. Yes, go ahead. In general, when Indian Renaissance is defined, yes, Indian railways वगैरह जो हैं, that again played a very important role because of distribution of newspaper, information available to masses. You can write that, but that will not be the main part of your answer. The main part hai wo jo cultural reform hai wo hai, and cultural reform in our society versus also fighting a common enemy, ye wale part pe zyada focus karna hai humko. Theek hai? Yes. See, but the thing is, even if you read the history of Indian National Congress, the emergence of Indian National Congress only happened after a certain organizations which were built in different part of the country, and the gradual transition was emergence of Indian National Congress. So this is actually not a counter argument. मतलब ये जो example है emergence of Indian National Congress, that actually shows that how this Renaissance led to emergence of national identity. So that actually will support the argument that how Indian Renaissance led to emergence of INC, emergence of Indian nationalism. It was, of course, it was in its nascent stages. No one is saying that India, for example, I can very well argue that Indian nationalism is not defined even today. So for example, when I ask this question, what unites us, you have some abstract ideas like idea of India, shared history. बट ये जो अभी भी हम क्वेश्चन कर सकते हैं कि इंडियन नेशनलिज्म को डिफाइन कैसे करें हम, दिस स्टिल कैन बी डिबेटेड. तो ये तो बहुत पहले की हम बात कर रहे हैं. इट इज अ वेरी डायनेमिक कॉन्सेप्ट. आवर कॉमन हेट्रेड अगेंस्ट पाकिस्तान. नो नो. चलो लेट्स कम टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. क्वेश्चन नंबर 11. Many voices had strengthened and enriched the nationalist movements during the Gandhian phase. Elaborate. अब देखो, इस क्वेश्चन का स्कोप इतना ज्यादा है, द स्कोप ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन इज सो ह्यूज एंड यू हैव टू राइट दिस आंसर इन 250 वर्ड्स. यू कैन एक्चुअली राइट एन एसे ऑन दिस टॉपिक. गांधियन फेज, व्हाट इज गांधियन फेज? 1917 टू 1947, राइट? दिस इज गांधियन फेज स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम चंपारण सत्याग्रह टिल वी गॉट इंडिपेंडेंस, राइट? सो दैट इज, that is, don't do that, that is Gandhian phase. So, and the question is that many voices had strengthened and enriched the national movement. Ab isme jitna bhi development hua hai 1917, sorry, I'm really sorry, okay, I'm talking about question number 11. Many voices had strengthened and enriched the nationalist movement during the Gandhian phase. Elaborate. 15 marks a question है. You have to write it in 250 words. क्या हो सकता है approach यहाँ पे? अच्छा, first of all, first thing which I will say here that there is not no single approach to write this answer. It can be answered in many number of ways, but you have to make sure that this answer should be exhaustive. For example, it should talk about the entire Gandhian phase, and second, it should contain, it should be written only in 250 words. Because अगर आप लिखने बैठो तो उसमें पूरा ऐसे लिख सकते हैं. Yes. Yes, we. That will come much later. That will come much later. But yes, Ambedkar will be a very important name here. But yes, you can start with that. He's saying that can we start from some external influences when Gandhi started his political movement in India? Yes, you can write that. And not only Russian Revolution. We can also talk about First World War itself. That influence of First World War. So yes, that can be a starting point. That when Gandhi started his active participation in Indian national movement, two important events, one was First World War and the another was Russian Revolution, that influenced our Gandhi's ideology as well as the developments in India. So yes, you can start with that, or you can start with Gandhi's very first movement itself, the Champaran Satyagraha, or you can start with Gandhi's ideas itself. How, before Gandhi, what was the characteristic of national movement and how Gandhi changed the nature of the movement itself. कर सकते हैं हम ये? So for example, you can always say, so yes, the masses participation, that will be the most important point, that taking movement to the masses and also the role, the methods of satyagraha, non-violence, truth. So ये सारी चीजें, that is the contribution of Gandhi in Indian freedom struggle. But this will only be part of introduction. This is not the main question. All the different stakeholders in Indian national movement. So for example, yes, I was coming to that only. ये जो many voices है, that is the question actually. What is this many voices? ये है क्या? तो many voices we are talking about that. So for example, take the case of INC itself, Indian National Congress ले लो, and इसके अलावा जो बाकी के organisations हैं. INC is not one single political entity. There are different voices within INC itself first, and apart from INC, there are many other stakeholders, there are many other voices, for example, revolutionaries, for example, role played by Ambedkar, socialist and communist. Yes, you're saying something. ये भी हो सकता है? Yes. दोनों हो सकते. ऐसा क्यों बोल रहे हो कि हमको एक ही करना है? We can write that. All the stakeholders, yes, we can start with all the stakeholders in Indian national movement. देखो, इस क्वेश्चन को आंसर करना, मैं वही बोल रहा हूँ, एक कोई इसका आंसर नहीं है. आपको बस 250 वर्ड्स में समराइज करना है. सो फॉर एग्जांपल, इफ आई हैव टू राइट दिस आंसर, आई विल स्टार्ट विथ, यहां से डिस्कस कर लो. यू हैव समथिंग टू से इस क्वेश्चन में? हाँ, यू वर डिस्कसिंग समथिंग. सो यस, वी कैन, सो फॉर एग्जांपल, पेजेंट, वी कैन टॉक अबाउट पेजेंट मूवमेंट, वी कैन टॉक अबाउट पार्टिसिपेशन ऑफ वुमन एंड स्टूडेंट्स विच स्टार्टेड इन नॉन कोऑपरेशन मूवमेंट. वी कैन ऑल्सो टॉक अबाउट खिलाफत मूवमेंट. सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल, non-cooperation movement का एक important characteristic क्या है? That it had a religious tone and for the first time Muslims participated in such a large number. And you can also provide in one or two line of criticism also, many voices ki baat kar rahe hain. So non-cooperation movement ka criticism ye bhi hai, that many leaders within the Congress itself did not like the fact that Congress is raising a religious issue which does not pertain to India also. Right? So Khilafat issue Turkey ka hai, Ottoman Empire ka hai, but India is starting a revolution for that. So that will be example of many voices, that there is a certain characteristic of our Indian national movement and we have to maintain that characteristic. Khilafat goes against it. So many leaders opposed it, yes. Both. Overall, it should be overall, not within the INC. कहीं पे question पे scope कहीं पे नहीं है कि खाली INC की बात करनी है. Yes, we can. I was coming to that. So for example, once NCM gets completed, within Congress itself, now there is Swarajist and No Changers. We know about the debate between Swarajist and No Changers. Sabko pata hai that their participation in legislative assembly. Swarajist wanted participation, No Changers did not want that. No Changers wanted to continue the Gandhian jo method hai, usko they wanted to continue. So that was also a debate within the Congress itself. We are talking about 1920s now. And in 1920s, a very important set of players also emerged. Those are revolutionaries. So we have to talk about revolutionaries here. Like people like Bhagat Singh, people like Chandrasekhar Azad, people like Lal Balpal to thode pehle aa gaye. We are talking about 1920s ke. So Sen. Sorry? Communist ideas baad mein aayenge. To main bol raha hu ki ek structure agar mujhe maintain karna ho, jaise if I have to write this answer and I have to write this answer in a structured format, to what I will do, I will write answer in a time period manner ki kaise cheeze develop hui hain. Instead of writing haphazard points, main 1920 se shuru kiya, maine 1917 se shuru kiya, and what developments happened after that we will write it. Yes. You can do that. I will just mention one thing. While writing that, do not restrict yourself just to Gandhian movements, because no, the question is not Gandhian phase. Gandhian phase hai wo time period ke liye. Question is this, ye jo many voices hai, ye sabse important part hai, which strengthened and enriched the nationalist movement. Ye hamara main part of the question hai. To agar hum Gandhian movement ko khali karenge, तो फिर हम आंसर के साथ जस्टिस नहीं करेंगे हम. सो अपार्ट फ्रॉम गांधी, व्हाट वेर अदर स्टेक होल्डर्स, व्हाट वेर अदर प्लेयर्स, इनफैक्ट उस पर ज्यादा हाईलाइट करना है हमको गांधी के रिस्पेक्ट में. गांधी को इंट्रोडक्शन में खत्म करो, इंट्रोडक्शन में गांधीयन मेथड पे बात करो, हाउ गांधी चेंज द कोर्स ऑफ मूवमेंट, फिनिश इट देयर एंड देन एंड देयर ओनली. इन द मेन पार्ट ऑफ द आंसर यू हैव टू राइट डिफरेंट स्टेक होल्डर्स, राइट. यस, नाउ वी व्हेन वी कम टू 1930s, अच्छा, इन 1928 वी कैन टॉक अबाउट नेहरू रिपोर्ट. यस, होम रूल थोड़ा पहले है गांधी, वी कैन स्टार्ट इन इंट्रोडक्शन. So home rule was used by Gandhi in Rowlatt Satyagraha. So we can talk about home rule, but वो बहुत पहले आएगा. अभी हम 20s and 30s की बात करें. 30s में the most important movement was Salt Satyagraha. And during civil disobedience movement also, there are a lot of stakeholders within Congress. So now socialists and communists are emerging. Now Ambedkar is becoming a very important player. Jinnah has also become a very important player. All these are all their voices you have to mention. So for example, what Ambedkar thought about Indian freedom movement and ideology of Congress, what Subhash Chandra Bose thought of Nehru report, what Jawaharlal Nehru thought of Nehru report. So for example, Subhash Chandra Bose and Nehru, they were socialist and they did not accept the Nehru report. So their voices are also important. Thoda aur aage chale jao, in late 1930s aa jao, there is a conflict between Gandhi and Subhash Bose now, that their participation in World War, Gandhi believed in something, Subhash Bose believed in something else, Nehru believed in something else. So you have to talk about that, how ideologically Congress in general, Congress in particular, and the entire Indian national movement in general evolved during Gandhian phase. Ye hamara main answer hoga. सो एक बढ़िया स्ट्रक्चर अगर हमको करना हो, बिकॉज पॉइंट्स लिखने के लिए सब लोग बहुत कुछ लिख के आए होंगे, एक जो बढ़िया स्ट्रक्चर होगा, ट्राई टू फॉलो अ टाइम पीरियड, बिकॉज द मोमेंट यू डू दैट योर स्ट्रक्चर विल बी बेटर एंड यू ऑटोमेटिकली विल रिमेंबर अ लॉट ऑफ पॉइंट्स. जस्ट डू नॉट मिस इंपॉर्टेंट स्टेक होल्डर. सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल, समबडी सेड दैट मुस्लिम लीग, यस यू हैव टू टॉक अबाउट मुस्लिम लीग, एंड नॉट ओनली मुस्लिम लीग, यू हैव टू टॉक अबाउट हिंदू महासभा एंड आरएसएस ऑल्सो. Enriched and strengthened nationalist movement, they did actually, in a way. So for example, their demand was two nation theory, and they enriched our national, because Congress did not accept it. So for example, India cannot be a nation of Hindus. So their contribution was that our jo secular ethos hai, it further got strengthened. You have to connect this dot. So Muslim League ka contribution ye hai, that Muslim League believed in later part of Muslim League politics, they believed in two nation theory. Congress clearly rejected it, that we do not accept this two nation theory. India cannot be a nation of only Hindus. So our secular ethos were strengthened because of Muslim League. So you can write that. You have to mention about Ambedkar here. Ambedkar is a very important stakeholder. You have to talk about Nehru, Subhash Chandra Bose, socialist, communist, peasant movement. So jitne bhi stakeholders hain, sabko mention karna hai. बस ट्राई टू फोकस ऑन द टाइम पीरियड. इसीलिए मैं बोल रहा हूं ये सारी चीजें हमको 250 वर्ड्स में भी लिखनी है, तो इसीलिए हम फोकस करेंगे कि हम मेन थीमेटिक वाइज डिस्कस करेंगे. जैसे फॉर एग्जांपल, आई डू नॉट हैव टू ड्वेल ऑन ईच एंड एवरीथिंग, बट जो मेन मेन डेवलपमेंट है, एंड स्पेशली जहां पे वेन एवर देर इज अ डिबेट, वी विल ट्राई टू हाईलाइट दोज डिबेट्स. ये जो एनरिचिंग होता है, एनरिचिंग एंड स्ट्रेंथनिंग होता है, दैट हैपेंस ओनली वाया डिबेट एंड डिस्कशन. सो वी हैव टू, and when there is an ideological difference, so we have to highlight those things in this answer. We can conclude it, how can we conclude it? So our constitutional ethos, that jo major contribution hai Gandhian phase ka, that is development of our Indian constitution itself, that there are certain characteristics of our Indian freedom struggle which are enshrined in our Indian constitution. So we can mention that, right? So this is a question where there is no fixed answer, proper analytical question, it, and you have to, you have a lot to write. Jaise for example, society mein bhi aise bahut sare question hai, jahan pe you have a lot to write, but the main key takeaway is that you have to maintain a proper structure. You cannot write your points in haphazard manner. You have to maintain a structure. Think, so aise question ko karne ka hamesha ek tarika hai, before, when you read the question, think for few seconds. And think for few seconds, organize your thoughts, ek structure ban jayega. So give at least 10 to 15 seconds to a question before writing the answer. Many times what happens is that students do not do it, but iska bahut value hai. Ye jo 10 second hai, aapko lagega ki nahi 10 second mein we can write a lot of words, but actually it has a lot of value. So especially in these questions where you have a lot to write, thinking for few seconds is very important. Okay, let's come to last two questions. Question number 12. Assess the role of British imperial power in complicating the process of transfer of power during the 1940s. Agar 1940s nahi rehta, tab to bahut hi zyada scope ho jata is question ka. But 1940s, because this question is talking about 1940s, at least there are two, three examples. India is just one of them. That's why this is a question of world history, not modern Indian history. But despite this question being a question of world history, the majority of your answer will be focused on India. And in fact, this is a trend which you can say that has been maintained by UPSC, that connecting Indian history with world history. There has been certain questions in this regard. For example, in 2015, there was a question that what were the main points in new economic policy adopted by Lenin? And the second part was, how it developed India's economic policy in initial years. So there was a connection there. Or jo last year ka question hai, last year ka world history ka question hai, that people, a lot of people migrated to different part of the world during British rule. You had to comment upon it and you have to discuss that have they been able to maintain their cultural identity. So ye jo ek theme hai, that connecting Indian history with world history, this is something which UPSC has continued again in this question. Apart from India, so India mein, jaise for example, what we have to do, 1940s mein India mein sabse bada problem kya tha? Achha, how can we start with this question? 1940s mein the biggest event which happened was World War II. World War II weakened the entire, not only British Empire, but the entire European Empire. And that was a click point which started the decolonization. Happened for the first time. So India was one of the first country which got independence. Later in African countries, they got independence in 50s and 60s. But humko 40s pe focus karna hai. So first thing which you have to ask, apart from India, which were the main countries which got independence in 1940s? China bahut pehle, China ka alag issue hai, China ko chodo. China was not completely colonized in any time of the history, although there were spheres of influences, and China had their own internal struggle between Communist Party and People Republic. So, ek alag issue hai. Yes, Malay Peninsula, but Malay Peninsula mein problems hai. Their freedom movement started in 40s, but they got independence in 50s. So, but yes, you can mention about Malay Peninsula also. There were some complications there also. We'll talk about that. What about other? Myanmar. Yes, Israel-Palestine is the most important country which you have to mention here. Israel was created in 1948, and at the same time Palestine got independence, and there the role played by Britishers are criticized a lot. Sri Lanka also got independence in 1948, but Sri Lanka ko hum skip kar sakte hain, but Sri Lanka mein aisa koi complication nahi hai. Toh jo sabse important example hai, that example is India itself. And in India, what were the main issues of contention? Yes, so there are two main issues. The first is, yes, the first is dominion status versus complete independence. And second is what to do with Muslim League demands. And these are the two main issues on which complications were created by British powers, especially in four important events before World War II. Started with August Offer. Nehru report to 1928 mein chale gaye hum. We're talking about 1940s. So August Offer, Cripps Mission, Wavell Plan, then Cabinet Mission, and finally Mountbatten Plan, hamara jo Indian Independence Act bana hai, Mountbatten Plan. So we have to briefly mention, so for example, a good structured answer here will be that there are two main issues, dominion status versus complete independence. Congress is demanding complete independence, Britishers are adamant on dominion status. Now in all this, and first, that is the first issue, and the second issue is what to do with Pakistan, the demand of Pakistan. In all these four offers, especially Mountbatten Plan, mein toh finally country was divided. No, there was a third issue also. Yes, princely states. What to do with princely states? So not two, but there are three main issues. And in all these demands, August Offer, Cripps Mission, Wavell Plan, Cabinet Mission, the Britishers tried to appease Indians, but they completely failed. So for example, in all these four demands, they only accepted dominion status. But on the question of Pakistan, there were differences. In August Offer, in Cripps Mission, in Wavell Plan, in Cabinet Mission also. For example, Cabinet Mission rejected the idea of Pakistan. But in Wavell Plan and Cripps Mission, it was accepted, okay, you can get independence. Jo princely states, they can get independence, Pakistan can also be formed. So there are a lot of differences within these four offers itself, which finally culminated into creation of both India and Pakistan. So that was the biggest complication caused by Britishers in India during 1940s. Okay? So ye main part of answer jo hoga, I think if I have to divide, 60% of the answer will be focusing on India itself. But the rest answer hai, that we have to talk about Israel and Palestine as well as Jordan. Yes. हाँ, बट इसराइल का इंडिपेंडेंस जो है, अभी हम बात करेंगे इस पे, हॉलोकास्ट के बाद जो ज्यूइश इमिग्रेशन है ना, उसके साथ जो अरब इसराइल कॉन्फ्लिक्ट है, दैट रीच्ड इट्स जेनिथ इन 1940s. हाँ, बट वी विल डिस्कस द रोल ऑफ ब्रिटिश, दैट हाउ ब्रिटिश रोल वाज क्रिटिसाइज्ड. बट लेट फर्स्ट डिस्कस डाउट्स हियर. यस, especially in India-Pakistan, India-China. India-Pakistan boundary dispute. So basically, see, the thing is that ye aap bol sakte ho, बट ये जो प्रिंसली स्टेट्स को जो वो दे दिया था कि यू कैन इधर ज्वाइन इंडिया और पाकिस्तान और यू कैन रिमेन इंडिपेंडेंट, सो बाउंड्री वॉज समथिंग विच ब्रिटिशर्स कुड नॉट डू एनीथिंग, बट यस यू कैन कनेक्ट इट विथ कश्मीर, दैट द कश्मीर इशू दैट वॉज ऑल्सो क्रिएटेड बाई ब्रिटिशर्स इट सेल्फ एंड दैट कश्मीर इशू इज स्टिल अ बोन ऑफ कंटेंशन बिटवीन इंडिया एंड पाकिस्तान. You can write that. You can write that, but you have to focus on the development in 1940s. So we can talk about the development which happened with respect to Kashmir. So yes, you can mention that example. So this will be the main one part of the answer. We have to talk about all these things and we have to talk about the three main issues and how all these plans had different orientation, that what to do ahead with these three main issues. India, Pakistan, princely states and dominion status, complete demand of complete independence. Now let's come to Israel Palestine. So ab Israel Palestine ka bhi background hai, that so as you rightly mentioned that Israel ka jo creation hai, that happened in Balfour Declaration. Britishers declared that there should be a separate home state for Jews in Palestine itself. So that was the first thing which happened. But during World War II especially, and even before World War II, there was a huge Jewish immigration in Palestinian state. Jo abhi hai, maximum number of people are Muslims. There are some Christians and some Jews. But during the course of World War I and World War II, the number of Jewish population is increasing in Palestine, state of Palestine. And especially during Hitler and his policies of Holocaust, there is a huge influx of Jews in Israel. Up now, and the demand of creation of a separate state is becoming stronger and stronger, and at this time British troops are there. Suddenly what happens in 1947, that Britain says that we are not able to deal with this situation, we are removing our troops, this situation should be dealt by United Nations. And the moment that happened, UN decided that there should be two states, Israel and Palestine, in 1948. And the moment Israel was created, it was attacked by many Arab countries. Although people thought that Israel will lose the war, but it did not. In fact, jitna UN ne diya tha unko, they even increased their land, their area, in the first Israel-Arab war itself. And that was not the end of it. Israel fought series of wars. It still is fighting. So abhi bhi chal raha hai, pura Middle East, aap log hamesha news mein padhte hi honge. So Israel-Palestine ka jo issue hai, that is also a British legacy. Why? Because what to do with the situation, they created the situation through Balfour Declaration, through huge Jewish immigrants, and finally they couldn't satisfy either Arabs or Israelis. So for example, Israelis thought that Britishers are pro-Arabs, they are not sentimental, they are not sympathetic towards Jewish cause. Arabs thought that they are pro-Jews, and in a Muslim region, they are creating a separate Jew state. So they could not satisfy either of the party, and they abruptly withdraw their entire troops. So for example, had British troops been there, they would have handled the violence which erupted after creation of Israel and Palestine. So that will be the second part of your answer. So that was a British complication, and that complication has also remained till date, like India and Pakistan. India-Pakistan ka issue abhi bhi hai, Israel-Palestine ka issue abhi bhi hai. So we have to highlight at least these two major examples. Okay? So first reading mein aisa lagta hai ki Indian history ka question hai, but this is not an Indian history question as such, but India will be one of the significant part of your answer. Any doubt here? In India, yes. Yes, of course, then we'll have to restrict. So, yes, that is a two things. Because of two things. First, there is a world history in your syllabus. First, and second thing, yes, you have a very genuine doubt. The second thing, ye jo British imperial power hai, this keyword. Imperial power is not limited to India. Jo British kingdom hai, British authority is not limited to India. First. And second, this keyword, transfer of power is nothing but decolonization. And decolonization is also not something specific to India. So because of these two keywords, you have to identify that, okay, this is not a question of Indian history as such, but this is a question of world history. Had this mentioned in India यहाँ पे, तो बहुत ही specific हो जाता, India specific हमको answer करना पड़ता. But अभी भी, as of now also, majority of your part, at least 60% of the answer will be India specific only. बहुत बात की बात है. सो फॉर एग्जांपल जो कॉमनवेल्थ, यस दैट हैपेंड, बट इस क्वेश्चन में उसका कोई रिलेवेंस नहीं है. मतलब वो कॉमनवेल्थ के बारे में बात करने का कोई मतलब नहीं है यहाँ पे. यस दे डिड दैट, बट दैट एक्चुअली डिड नॉट लीड टू अ लॉट ऑफ कॉम्प्लिकेशन. इन फैक्ट इट लेड टू कॉपरेशन एमंग हिथेरटू ब्रिटिश कॉलोनीज. सो वी कैन स्किप दैट, मतलब उसको लिखने की जरूरत नहीं है सच. ओके, लेट्स कम टू द लास्ट क्वेश्चन विच आई हैव टू डिस्कस. Assess the role of, explain how the foundations of the modern world were laid by American and French Revolution. People were very happy because world history ka syllabus bahut bada hai. And this is the first thing, second, third thing which you read. You start your syllabus with Industrial Revolution, then you read American Revolution, and then you read French Revolution. So this was a very basic question, and I am very sure whoever has read world history, you have a lot of points to contribute here. कैसे करेंगे इसको, कैसे लिखेंगे, व्हाट विल बी स्ट्रक्चर, नॉट पॉइंट्स, व्हाट विल बी द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ योर आंसर. जो पॉलिटिकल डेवलपमेंट्स हैं, यस, सो यस, व्हाट इज सेइंग दैट वी हैव a good structure will be. So for example, because it is a 15 marks question, 250 words mein likhna hai. So a brief should be written about, I think, in introduction about American and French Revolution itself. A brief, the keyword is brief here, like in 20-30 words, 20 words about American Revolution, 20-30 words about French Revolution. So what happened in American Revolution? The colonists say they revolutioned against their own colonizers. So the American Revolution was actually done by Britishers themselves against the British Empire. We know that, right? That's why American Revolution is considered as a revolution done by traitors. So the settlers were Britishers then only, but they did not like the arbitrary taxation which was being imposed, and it was increased without their consultation. So that was the key cause which led to American Revolution. And in this American Revolution, France supported America. जो कॉलोनीज 13 कॉलोनीज थे, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ अमेरिकन रिवॉल्यूशन फ्रेंच रिवॉल्यूशन स्टार्टेड. फ्रांस वाज ऑलरेडी इन पॉवर्टी, देयर वाज एन ऑटोक्रेटिक रूल, देयर इज अ डेस्पोटिक रेजिम, एंड दैट रेजिम इज फाइटिंग वॉर्स अक्रॉस द वर्ल्ड व्हाइल प्राइसेस ऑफ ब्रेड एंड नॉर्मल कंज्यूमर गुड्स आर सोरिंग हाई. सो इन वेरी ब्रीफ यू हैव टू टॉक अबाउट अमेरिकन रिवॉल्यूशन एंड फ्रेंच रिवॉल्यूशन, नॉट मोर देन 20 और 30 वर्ड्स, दैट शुड बी द लिमिट. And the second part of jo question hai, wo humko, jo main part of the question hai, that contribution of American and French Revolution, especially jo keyword hai, foundation of the modern world. Now this is very important. So for example, if I have to talk about American Revolution, what are some contribution of American Revolution to modern world? So yes, it started with no taxation, without representation. No taxation without representation. Yes, Bill of Rights is very important. The fundamental rights, which are integral part of almost all democratic constitution across the world, this happened for the first time in American Revolution. What else? Yes, this is the first federal. So 13 jo colonies hain. These 13 colonies are independent of each other. They fought against a common enemy. And at that time, they were considered as these United States of America. And these became the. So this is the reason why aur kisi country ke aage the nahi lagta hai. But USA ke aage hum the lagate hain. Hota hai na? The India kahin pe nahi likha hoga. But the United States of America. Why? Because it became a country from states. Generally क्या होता है, country जो है खुद को states हम divide करते हैं for administrative efficiency. Here many states came together and these United States of America became the United States. So the concept of federalism है. This again happened in USA, American Revolution. What else? Sorry? Yes, written constitution. Yes, that is a very good point. Written constitution. And ye jo written constitution hai, this is based on a concept called social contract. The theory of social contract given by John Locke, that people are willing to form a government, but people are the main authority. People are the sovereign here. So government only has the moral authority to rule as long as that rule is not arbitrary. As long as the power of that government is limited. The concept of constitutionalism hai. So that again started in American Revolution. Now this was an idea propounded by John Locke and other philosophers, but in implementation form it happened after American Revolution. So theory of social contract. अच्छा अब यहां पे दो चीजें हैं. दीज आर पॉलिटिकल आइडियाज विच हैपेंड आफ्टर अमेरिकन रिवॉल्यूशन विच हैव इंस्पायर्ड मॉडर्न वर्ल्ड पॉलिटीज. बट व्हाट अबाउट द डेवलप्ड पॉलिटिकल हिस्ट्री इटसेल्फ? सो फॉर एग्जांपल अमेरिकन रिवॉल्यूशन, वन ऑफ द इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सिक्वेंस ऑफ अमेरिकन रिवॉल्यूशन इज राइज ऑफ यूएसए एज सुपर पावर, राइट? जो अभी वर्ल्ड है, जो यूएसए इतना पावरफुल कंट्री है, दैट स्टार्टेड विथ अमेरिकन रिवॉल्यूशन. And America was a very, USA was a very secluded country in world till World War I. Even after World War I, it maintained a policy of seclusion. But after World War II, it became two of the major powers after USSR. Another was USSR. So yes, you can mention that also. Developments in political ideas as well as political history. So ye political ideas hai, but this also contributed to development in political history. And that political history is very important till now. Now let's come to French Revolution. Yes. Yes, you can write that. Yes, jo Bill of Rights, we can talk about the Republic. Ye jo people as a sovereign ruler hai, ye democracy ke liye bahut integral part hai. Yes, we can write that. Democracy, not only democracy, even George Washington the. And Thomas Jefferson, they were very much against separation of business and state. Why? Because this lack of separation had created monopolies in many European countries, be it France or Britain. So they believed Adam Smith's idea. So Adam Smith propounded the theory of capitalism. So they tried to laissez-faire. We have to make market free of the government regulation. Why? Because if there is a direct connection between market and government, and especially if government is controlling every aspect of market, then it will lead to creation of monopolies. So you can mention that also, and that is something which we still follow in different forms. The liberal economy ka concept hai. Yes, you can write that. So what about French Revolution? End of slavery happened after the American Civil War. So that did not happen just after the American Revolution. So after American Revolution, when Abraham Lincoln became president, slavery was abolished. So usko skip kar sakte hain yahan pe. What about French Revolution? Yes, Bill of Rights jo hai, fundamental rights hi hai. So that we learned. Liberty, equality, fraternity, French Revolution, American Revolution, dono mein commonalities hain, you can write that. But French Revolution ke some important points. Give me that. The very first and the very most important will be the concept of nation itself. The rise of nation states, that is a direct consequence of French Revolution. Sorry? Treaty of Westphalia? So, ye jo nation hai, but jo emergence of nation state hai, that nation based on certain values. So for example, as a theory versus as being implemented. So French Revolution inspired series of revolutions in Europe in 1830 and 1848, which led to emergence of many new European countries like Belgium, Holland, etc. So we can write that. So emergence of nation states also. Yes, somebody talked about secularism. Yes, secularism is a very important characteristic of French Revolution. Idea of liberty, equality and fraternity. It inspired revolutions in 1830s and 48. And why this is important for modern world? Because यहाँ पे जो countries बने थे 1830-48 में बहुत सारी countries got independence and this country still exist today. So we can write that many European countries were emerged. And there are certain points which will be common here. So for example, very strong opposition to autocratic rule. That is a common characteristic between both American and French Revolution. However, there is irony there. French Revolution started against autocratic rule, but Napoleon became the emperor. So again, it ended with autocratic rule. So, but at least on principle, French Revolution was against autocratic and despotic regime. So we can write that. So there are many points which you can mention here. Acha, what about socialism? Did French Revolution somehow contributed to socialism? It did. So socialism ka jab aap history padhoge, so two major events which led to the development of idea of socialism. One is Industrial Revolution which happened in England and the another is French Revolution itself. Why socialism? Because when French Revolution happened, French Revolution ka agar aapko thoda sa history batao, it was led by, there were three states, right? There were three states, first, second and third. First mein noble hai, clergy hai. Third state mein middle class hai as well as peasants hai. Ab these peasants are more than 80% of the population. And initial phases of French Revolution was led by middle classes. These middle classes are businessmen. They are artists. They are novelists. So aise log hai. Now when actually revolution happened, the peasant class was very much unsatisfied with the outcome. Their lives had not improved a lot. So socialism not only started in England, but it also had its origin in French Revolution also. In later part of French history, jab hum padhenge, to France played a very important role in emergence of socialism. So you can write that also. Idea of socialism. But ek, जब हम लिखेंगे आइडिया ऑफ सोशलिज्म तो एक लाइन लिखना पड़ेगा कि ये फ्रेंच रिवॉल्यूशन का यूनिक चीज नहीं है. दिस हैपेंड बोथ बिकॉज ऑफ एक्सप्लॉयटेशन आफ्टर इंडस्ट्रियल रिवॉल्यूशन इन इंग्लैंड एज वेल एज फ्रेंच रिवॉल्यूशन. सो यस, देर आर कॉमनैलिटीज बिटवीन बोथ दिस रिवॉल्यूशन. आप कॉमन पॉइंट्स भी आप लिख सकते हो, बट देर आर सेपरेट कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑल्सो विच यू कैन मैंशन सेपरेटली. कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ अमेरिकन रिवॉल्यूशन, कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ फ्रेंच रिवॉल्यूशन. दिस वॉज वन ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन जो बहुत थोड़ा बहुत मुश्किल है, मतलब ऐसे है कि हम पढ़ते हैं. यस, गो अहेड. यस, थोड़ा सा डिफरेंस है. यस, यू आर राइट. सो इक्वालिटी एज आइडिया एंड सोशलिज्म एज आइडिया, देर आर कॉमनैलिटीज बट डिफरेंसेज हैं, तो इसीलिए हम इनको सेपरेट लिखा है. इक्वालिटी, लिबर्टी, फ्रेटर्निटी, सोशलिज्म को हम अलग से हम लिख सकते हैं. एनी डाउट इन हिस्ट्री एंड आर्ट एंड कल्चर, बिकॉज आई एम डन विथ ऑल दिस क्वेश्चन. रेस्ट ऑफ द क्वेश्चन अंजनी सर विल टेक. एनी डाउट हियर? यस, यू कैन. द आइडिया ऑफ रिपब्लिकनिज्म स्टार्टेड इन, यस यू कैन राइट दैट. यू कैन राइट दैट ऑल्सो सेपरेट. जो सेकुलरिज्म का कॉन्सेप्ट है, यस यू कैन राइट दैट. चलो, रेस्ट ऑफ द क्वेश्चंस अंजनी सर विल टेक.